Hello students, in this lecture we will learn about service pipes and its fundamentals. Service pipes. Water to the building, apartments, etc. come from the municipal water supply called as water main. The pipe which connects this main water pipe to the building is called as service pipes. Later, these pipes run to the water tank and then up to the set points and fixtures. Service pipes are of the utmost importance to have proper water distribution in the building. Service pipes means the pipes which connects the main water supply coming from the municipal corporation to the building is known as service pipes, and these service pipes later run throughout the building to reach to the taps which we will be using. The pipe material selection criteria. How the pipe material is to be selected? The parameters for this are: first is the initial cost. To see the initial cost, the cheapest one or the most economical one. Second, the maintenance cost, it should be minimum. Easy to work with, it should be easy to work with, easy to assemble, easy to install. Life of the material should be high so that it should be durable, and the life of the material should be such that it should sustain for a longer time. Types of pipes. There are about 7 types of pipes we will be dealing now, starting from the copper pipe to the stoneware pipe. Let's see one by one. Copper pipe. Copper pipes are made up of copper. It has great tensile strength. That is, they can be elongated when they are pulled in the opposite directions. They can sustain and will not break easily. They have adequate ductility. They are highly corrosion resistive. Acidic water or the water with high pH value can be easily used and be safe enough for these pipes. They can be used in thin walls. They can be used for both cold and hot water supply. Second, cast iron pipes. They are made up of gray cast iron. They are rust and corrode very easily. They can rust and corrode very easily irrespective of the pH in the water. They rust very easily. They are strong and with hot water pressure hold water pressure and weight of dirt from the water. That is, they can hold the water pressure coming in these pipes, and the weight, the dirt, can be easily maintained and can be forwarded later irrespective of the cracking and so on. As the cross section, we can see the cross section is also heavy and is used for long distance traveling of the water. Third is galvanized or GI pipe. These pipes are made up of applying zinc coat on cast iron or the steel for protecting it from the rusting. As in the earlier case, the rusting was the prominent feature. Here this rusting is overcome by applying the zinc coating on the cast iron or on the steel pipes. They are economical than the copper pipes but costlier than the PVC pipes. They are strong than the copper pipes. They can corrode in mild to acidic water, thus repiping is needed after few years of use. All those houses today which are built about 20 to 30 years ago, all those houses are sure to have these GI pipes, and thus they are rusted till now, and repiping system or repiping is in continuous process for those houses. And the cleaning, the maintenance cannot be done by the acids like in the pipe, plastic pipes. We can do the cleaning of those pipes by using the acidic water. These pipes cannot be used or can't be done for that practice. Now, fourth is the cross-linked polythene pipe, also known as PX, PEX or XPE pipe. It is made up of modified medium or high density polyethylene and is flexible in nature. It needs less maintenance, fixing is easy and fixing is fast. Initial cost is high. It has large application ranging from the building services, offshore piping, sewage and chemical transportation. It can be used for both cold and hot water supply. Better option to copper pipes, as they are durable enough with comparison to the copper pipes, so better than the copper pipes. Damages due to insect attack and UV rays, so unfit for outdoor use. It can't be used for outdoor purposes as the insect can curtail or just drain off the water due to the eating of the plastic material, and UV rays can't be, means in the UV rays, it can't sustain those rays. The fifth is plastic or PVC pipe. The PVC pipe means polyvinyl chloride pipe. They are lightweight, easy to install, and thus easy to use. They are corrosion resistant, as there is no metallic surface, as there is no use of metal in this pipe, they are corrosion resistant. Now, there are other few types of these pipes. The first is unplasticized PVC or UPVC. They are useful in low to 45 degree Celsius temperature. These are the UPVC pipes. The second is chlorinated PVC or CPVC. They are flexible than the PVC pipe. They can be used for both hot and cold water supplies. They are useful up to 120 degree Celsius temperature. This is the figure of your CPVC. And one more thing, in generally, they have the red coating on it. This red color of strips, which shows that it is a CPVC pipe. These are used when to connect the solar water heater to the taps or to the geysers and the taps, so that it can't be, means it will not be damaging. On the other hand, the simple, the UPVC, they have the green coating or the blue coating over it. Plasticized pipe, they are weaker than the UPVC pipe, useful for the temperature up to 45 degrees Celsius temperature. So this is all about the PVC pipes. Asbestos cement pipe and stoneware pipe. On an average, these pipes are heavy weighted, cheap in quality and material, less efficient, needs proper handling, and used in low construction cost. These are the asbestos cement pipe and these are the stoneware pipe. They are used, they are formed by the asbestos cement pipe. These are the asbestos cement pipe and these are the stoneware made from the heating of the mud and in the foams. So they are on both are heavy weighted. They are of the cheap quality, less efficient because due to the water, they are prone to the leakages and less efficient comparing to the earlier PVC pipes and other pipes. They are less efficient, need proper handling because they are easy to break. They are brittle enough compared to the PVC and the metallic pipes. Used in low construction cost as they were earlier very cheap in the amount or they were pretty economical. But now if we go and search, it is general trend. If the things which are rare in the market will surely cost you high. Now they are hardly used because they are brittle, they are heavy to handle and the maintenance is also high and so on. So on various basis, they are now avoided. Now let's see the another point, the pipe connections, that is pipe fittings. Pipe connections are also called as pipe fittings. they are used to join two pipes of same or different sizes to increase the running length. Earlier, we have seen the pipes and the pipe materials. Now we are seeing the pipe connections, which joins the two pipes and increase their lengths. They are used to distribute the flow of water from the main source or main pipes. They are used to divert, change, and control the flow of water. They are used to divert, that is to change the direction of the flow, to change the flow and control the flow. The basic types of pipe connections fittings are, we will be seeing the 8 types, starting from the elbow, T, cross, coupling, nipple, cap, plug, and gasket. The first is elbow. Elbow joins the two pipes and divert flow of the liquid. There are two types, 45 degree elbow and 90 degree elbow. And they change the direction of in the 45 degrees and 90 degrees. This is the 90 degree elbow. 90 degree, and this is the 45 degree elbow. To change in the respective direction, water coming from here will go change the direction by 90 degree or vice versa. The different sized pipes can also be joined by using reducing type of elbow. If it is a 2-inch part, 2-inch pipe is here and here is a 1-inch pipe. So this elbow will be a 90 degree reducer elbow or 90 degree reducing elbow. Same for the 45 degree elbow also. The second is T. T's have one inlet and two 90 degree outlets to split the liquid in two different directions or vice versa. So the T, as the general T is like this. So here we have the entry, one inlet and two outlets like this, or two inlets and one outlet. Both can be there depending upon the situation. They are used to connect pipes of different sizes and different materials. We can use this T for connecting the pipes of two different sizes and materials also. Available in single T socket and double T socket. Here you should see that this is a cast iron T and this is a plastic T. Depending upon the pipe what has to be connected, we can connect those two pipes and the T is to be selected likewise. The threads here are called as female threads, and here it is a plastic. The pipe is connected by applying a solution and fixing it up. The third is cross. Cross have one inlet and three outlet or vice versa. There are one inlet and three outlet like this or vice versa, anything. Also called as four-way fittings. Here the water comes from one direction and spreads in three direction or vice versa. Uncommon in use and are costly, used in fire sprinklers or irrigation system. They are uncommon and generally used in the firefighting devices and at that time or the irrigation purpose. Connecting four different pipes. Coupling. Coupling are used to join the two pipes of same size. If it joins the pipes of different diameters, it is known as reducing coupler or reducer. This is the female threaded coupler. Female threaded coupling. Your pipes are connected to increase their length, then these are used. This is a female threaded coupling and this is a male threaded coupling. In female threaded, the threads are inside the coupling, that element, and in this, the threads are outside. Nipple. Nipple consists of pipe fitting with male pipe thread on both sides. It is used to join two fittings at small distance. To increase the distance of the pipe by a small distance, this nipple is used. On the both sides, we have these male threads. This is also male thread and this is also male thread. And then to increase the length by a smaller distance, they are used. Many a time they are used in the walls. This fitting can be seen in the walls. Next is cap. Cap is used to stop the flow of liquid from the pipe. That is to seal off the pipe and to stop the flow of water at the end points, at the dead ends. It is a female threaded and fits over the pipe. The pipe will be here and it will be fitted over here. And there are female threads. This is a metallic cap and this is a plastic cap. Both having female threads. Just you need to close off as we close off our bottles. The bottle caps are also having the female threads. The seventh is plug. It also seals off the pipe. It is used to stop the flow of the liquid from the pipe. It is a male threaded and fits in the pipe. These are the male threads and this plug goes inside the pipe, whereas the cap is above the pipe. These are the male threads. This is a metallic plug and this is a plastic plug. The eighth is gasket. The gasket is used as sealing material when joining the two pipes. They are generally ring shaped and placed in between two pipes before sealing to avoid leakages. When two pipes are joined, it is kept between those two pipes and fitted around. It is expected that the gasket should fill up the or seal up the small tiny spaces in between those two pipes or two things. And it is also expected that the gasket should deformed to some extent, to such an extent that it should seal off the internal voids. Thus, to seal the things, to seal the pipes. What we learned in this lecture, we learned about service pipes, the pipes which joins the building with the main pipe, main water supply, and runs throughout the building to get the water into our taps. The pipe material selection criteria, it should be, the material should be compared, should be assessed on the quality, its cost, its maintenance, its durability, its lifespan. Types of pipes, what are the different types of pipes, starting from the copper pipe to the asbestos and cement pipes. Asbestos, cement pipe and the other type. And later we studied about the pipe connections fitting. 8 types of pipe connections starting from the T and ended up to the gasket. That's it for now. Thank you.